Hello, it's been a while, and today I'm going to repair this little light fixture. This is a little moving head that has an issue with the gobo wheel and the focus. So let's put it on.
And after a while, we get this error.
Yeah, we have an issue, so let's disassemble it. Oops, wrong side. But at least I get to take a look at what's inside. And this is it. Wow, this is super compact and very tiny. So there is a little regulator board here for the fan. I'm going to remove. It's a little connector, right? I'll keep the screw back where I found it so that I don't lose it. And so we've got a little microcontroller here. And what looks like some motor driver here. And the regulator. What I'm going to do is swap some motor. And I will, that way I can check if it's rather a sensor issue, a motor issue, or a cable issue, or a driver issue. And I hope it's not a driver issue because I'm not very able to replace them. They're super tiny.
And unfortunately,
after spending 30 minutes swapping stuff around, I managed to isolate the problem, and it's the fucking driver. So yeah, it's quite difficult to repair.
Normally, with this kind of scenario, I would have tried to find a new board. And of course, because it's not a very famous brand like Leipaki or Martin, for example, I wouldn't find it, and so I would just give up on the project. But this time I want to try to actually swap the actual driver, but it's not on a traditional level of skills that I'm doing in this channel. Normally I would just take the big soldering iron and start soldering stuff on this one. I need to go with something a little bit more precise.
Too big because somebody lent me where it is.
Oh fuck, I forgot to film this part.
Well, you saw it at the beginning of this video anyway. It's this big ass welder soldering station that somebody lent me for this project. It consists of a precision soldering iron, this soldering iron that doesn't work, but we don't need it for this project anyway. And that's very interesting, a fine heat gun. And that's going to be very helpful for this project. After swapping in a questionable manner each driver, I managed to isolate that the fault is actually the driver and not another component on the motherboard, which is something quite nice, because I saw that you can buy those exact driver chip on AliExpress for a reasonable price, so this is what I'm going to do.
Well, now I'm just going to remove the old sender. Alright. And then I'll apply just a tiny bit. And now let's introduce the new component. I bought three pieces, but only have two to repair, so hopefully I've got a last chance on this one. First thing first, let's apply some flux. This will help the solder to melt, and it's very, very good for doing this kind of job. Now I'll align the pin, kind of alright. And then I grab the heat gun. And let's go. This is good. That's it. Now the unit has cooled down, so I can plug the thing back together. Yes! Nice. So yeah, the focus is working back and the prism, I saw it moving left and right. So this is very good. And yes, we have no error message. That's very good. This is working fine.
And this is it. I hope you like this video. Don't forget to like it, share it, and subscribe. And I see you for another project, hopefully very soon. Have a nice day.